When you take a look at the top five in home runs in MLB in 2021, there are a lot of familiar names. Rafael Devers has really broken out this year for the Red Sox. Shohei Ohtani has shown ability never before seen at the plate this year for the Angels. Ronald Acuna's had a great stretch here to end May. And Vladimir Guerrero Jr., son of Vlad Sr., needs no introduction. But there's one guy at the top of the leaderboard who you might never have heard of. That's Adolis Garcia. The slugger for the Rangers has put up 16 home runs in just 42 games. So where did he come from? What's his story? Why hadn't anyone heard of him before? All of that and more coming up in this episode. If you guys want to see more content like this on my channel, be sure to let me know. But for now, make sure to leave a like and subscribe so that more people can see this video. Jose Adolis Garcia Arrieta, a little baseball connection there with his other last name, born on March 2nd, 1993 in Cuba. He played for Ciego de Avila in the Cuban National Series. According to Rangers radio broadcaster Eric Nadel, Adolis got the nickname El Bumby because he had a head shaped like a bomber hat, and his friends when he was little in Cuba used to make fun of him for it. A bit of a playful story. Garcia barely saw any success out of the gate, and he actually had to defect from Cuba. If you know anything about that process or the story of Jose Fernandez, you know that that is a life or death process, but it did work, and he signed with the Cardinals in February of 2017. That year, he got a non-roster invite to spring training with the Redbirds, so things were looking on the up and up. He spent 2017 with both Springfield and AAA Memphis, where he posted a combined 290 batting average with 15 homers and 65 RBI. Garcia was actually never considered a big prospect for the Cardinals. He received just a 55 grade for his power in a 2019 prospect grade. That's a little above average when it comes to the scouting vernacular. In just 21 games with St. Louis, he hit just 118 and was designated for assignment on December 18th of 2019. Still, the Cardinals didn't think that his power was enough, and in December of 2019, they shipped him to the Rangers for cash considerations. In 2020, he barely got a cup of coffee at the big league clubs with the Rangers, just 6 at-bats in the COVID shortened season. He did get a spring training invite in 2021, and that's where things have really taken off for him. He posted an elite OPS of 1.170 in just 32 ABs. Rangers hitting coach Luis Ortiz has been credited with some of Garcia's development. He worked with him right after the Rangers got him from the Cardinals. He told the Dallas Morning News that he knew that there was work to be done, that the talent was there, but his skill at making contact and keeping the ball to the middle was something that he really had to master. A lot of people are confusing Adolis with his brother Adonis. You might recognize that name. He did get a lot of playing time with the Braves in 2015 and 2016. But like Adolis, he started out his career bouncing around the minors. Hit 10 homers with a 277 batting average and 191 ABs. And became just the second Atlanta player to hit 10 home runs in under 200 at-bats. After that, though, his career kind of tailed off, and he didn't make a big league roster after that. He played a couple seasons in the KBO League and bounced around with several other Mexican League teams. Funny enough, Adolis actually had a similar story. He made his professional debut in 2016 with the Yomiuri Giants of the Nippon Professional Baseball League in Japan. So from Cuba to Japan, to the Cardinals, to the Rangers. By the time opening day came around this year, Adolis Garcia was a well-traveled individual. The Rangers entered 2021 with limited expectations due to a thin pitching staff, and Adolis actually didn't even start out the season on the big league roster. But with injuries to Willie Calhoun, Sin-Soo Chu leaving the previous offseason, and Chris Davis starting out the season on the IL, it was quickly a hole opened up for Adolis. Since getting the call in mid-April, he has been one of the league's best hitters, slugging to a 2.9 WAR, a slugging over 600, OPS plus at 153, and tied again with Vlad Jr. for the league's lead in home runs. He's also flashed a little leather and proven himself valuable in the outfield, fielding his position as well. Where did this sudden power surge come from, and is it sustainable? There are definitely some questioning whether this power run is sustainable. Deep dive in the numbers, you see that Garcia is in the 96th percentile, according to StatCast, in hard hit balls. Hard hit balls, pitchers throwing harder than ever, some struggling to control their stuff. It's going to lead to a lot of home runs, and Adolis has absolutely feasted on that. Also found a way to hit on the road. Globe Life Field, the new home of the Rangers, has been notoriously difficult for batters to get a hold of in the early going, but Adolis has really stepped up in Rangers away game. And last weekend against the Astros, he showed what he can do with a 3-run walk-off home run to win the first game of the series, 2 more in the Saturday game of that 3-game set, and then a walk-off single in Sunday's game. Garcia is a shooting star, and his story is one that has to be seen to believe. If this is sustainable, the Rangers could have found a huge get in their scouting department pretty much for nothing. But let me know what you think about Adolis Garcia. Will he be the Rangers All-Star Game representative? But thanks so much for watching. Appreciate you tuning in for this little short video on the rise of Adolis Garcia. If you want to see more content like this on my channel, be sure to let me know in the comments section below. What do you want to see next? What are your expectations for the rest of the year for Adolis Garcia? Wishing you peace and wellness. Hope that this somehow brightened your day. We'll see you in the next one.